Today we're going to quickly go over two topics, gain staging and level matching your plugins. Now there seems to be a lot of confusion about gain staging all over the interwebs, but it is really, really simple. Now we're not going to get into the analog end of things today. We're just going to go through gain staging at your audio interface, inside your DAW, and at your master fader. Alright gang, so the first rule of gain staging when you're plugging something directly into your audio interface is don't clip your converters. That's it. That's the rule. As long as you have a decent, healthy signal and you're nowhere near clipping, you're good. That's it. It's that easy. And with that said, let's dive into the computer and I'll show you what I mean. Alright, so we're here inside of Logic, but again, don't worry about it being Logic. Everything I'm going to show you today is applicable in any DAW that you're using. Okay, so first things first, you're going to want to make sure that you have input monitoring turned on, which in Logic is this little button. If you happen to not see this button, all you need to do is right click up here, go to Customize Control Bar and Display, a little dialog box is going to pop up, and make sure that pre-fader metering is checked, and then just hit OK. When this is green, you're going to have pre-fader metering. So what that means is as you're seeing the meters go up and down with the audio, those meters are reflected before the audio hits the fader. This is going to help us later on when we're level matching the plugins. So besides the level meters on your audio interface, another way to double check when you have input metering turned on is when you're recording audio. You see this little line right at your mixer, it's sitting at about minus 10 dB. So at the top of the fader, you're at about minus 6 dB, and at the bottom, you're just about minus 18. So if your audio input coming in is somewhere in this range, you're good to go. You're not going to be clipping your converters. You're not going to be clipping inside your DAW. You're fine. So that part is pretty easy. So to show you what I'm talking about, I recorded a guitar track earlier and I'll play it back and just keep an eye on the meters. Now, if you saw on the meters here, and you can see where the maximum peak was minus 12.3 dB. This is a pretty good healthy range. You could go a little hotter, you're gonna be fine. But again, this is about the range that you wanna be in. And that's the first part of gain staging. Easy, right? I told you it'd be easy. Nothing to it. So now let's get into level matching between plugins. Now you might ask why level matching is important. The way our ears work, if something is louder, we perceive it as sounding better. But that's not necessarily the case. So for instance, if you have a guitar track and you put a compressor on it, you don't want the compressor volume to be louder, therefore making the track seem hyped up and sound better when it might not actually sound better at all. But if you've level matched the plugin, if you turn the compressor on and off, you'll be able to hear what the compressor is doing to the track. You're not going to hear any difference in volume, so you'll actually be able to hear whether the compressor is improving the track or taking away from the track without any of the hype getting in the way. So come on, I'll show you how to do it. So I'm going to reset these meters here quickly, and we'll just play this guitar track, the original guitar track from earlier. And again, we're peaking at minus 12.3 dB. So now, let's open up a guitar amp. So now if we play this track with the amp on, minus 12.4. So the same level, right? So whether I turn the amp on or off, the sound's going to change, but the level's the same. So now, let's just run it through a preamp, and we'll do the same thing. We're going to reset. We're going to turn this preamp on. We're going to play it back again. Again, minus 12.3. This is what I'm talking about with level matching. So you can add some drive, you can add some gain, whatever you need to do, but just pull down the fader a little bit, the output fader. This is going to vary between plugin to plugin, but you can use this to control the level coming out of that plugin going into the next one. So now with that on, we're going to reset again. We're going to add a compressor to it. We'll play this one more time. Again, pretty much the same level. And again, we'll add a tape plug-in on it. And 12.5. And that right there is level matching in a nutshell. All you need to do is make sure that if you turn a plug-in on or off, there's no real change in volume. That way you can hear exactly what a plugin is doing without being fooled, because now the track is a lot louder and you're being tricked into thinking it sounds better when it might not necessarily sound better. And if you have some really good sounding analog model plugins, you can still drive them. Some of these plugins sound really great when you really drive them hard, which you can still do. But again, just compensate by lowering the output of that plugin. So again, if you turn the plugin off and on, the volume level is still going to be the same. That way you can still drive the plugin hard and get that nice saturation and distortion, but you're keeping the level consistent going into the next plugin. And now we'll get into the last portion, the master fader. So when it comes to the master fader, there's two simple rules to live by. Number one, don't ever clip it. Ever. And rule number two, if you're going to be sending your track off to be mastered, leave about 6 dB of headroom for the mastering engineer to do his work. So all that means is if you're playing back your song, make sure that the loudest peaks in the song are only hitting about minus 6 dB on your meter. And I'll show you a quick and easy way to do that. So let's dive back into the computer. So let's just pretend for argument's sake that we have a full song here. Say we got 24 tracks of all sorts of stuff. Now all your individual tracks might be peaking, say, around minus 12-ish, give or take. But as you sum them to a bus, they might actually be peaking further up, because as you sum all these channels together, it's going to cause the audio to get louder. And then when the buses sum all together into the master fader, it's going to cause that to be louder as well. And there's a dead simple fix for that. If your bus is getting a little too hot, all you have to do is add a simple gain plugin and just dial it back a little bit. That'll take care of that problem. And same thing on the master fader. Put the same gain plugin in, dial it down a little bit, you're good. Just remember, even on your buses and on your master fader, you want to be level matching your plugins the same as you would on any other track. One quick caveat about using the gain plugin on your buses or your master fader. If you've added compressors and whatnot to the buses or master fader and you still find that it's still a little bit too hot coming out, don't turn down this first gain plugin, because if you do, it's going to affect all the plugins that are following that. So your compressor's not going to be reacting the same, so on and so forth. So what you'd want to do in that instance is just take the very last plugin that you have, and if it has an output meter on it somewhere, or an output volume, level, something, just turn that down and you'll be good to go.